Hello and good day. I'm Ilechukwu Alex. I'm going to take you through how our latest design was made, the Sunset Valley, created this year, 2015, February. We're going to go through the slides because we've already taken a screen capture of the design, design processes. But I must warn you, if you are trying to repeat this design or the better design, make sure you spend a lot of time working on it. Professional graphic designs are not designs you just rush and do under 1 hour or 2 hours. You spend more time on designs and you're going to get better results. I must confess, the design was completed February this year, 2015. But it wasn't actually started this year. It was started late last year. Although we have been designed at our leisure time, free time. But the trick is to spend more time on designs and know what actually you want to design. And the second warning is some of the stages you see and then you don't see them again. Or some you don't see the stages at all. You just see the design has already been done. Don't worry, we didn't get all the 100% of the stages, but we made sure we got at least 90-something% of the stages of the design. Well, if you are going to be a professional graphic artist, I believe you should actually learn how to create some things on your own. Not everything will be done. Will be given to you in a whole. You can actually improvise and then have a better design than the one you're watching or better design than the one you're seeing or the one you are reading about. First of all, I'm going to dive into this design and then let's see how it goes. So I'm going to take it step by step, stage by stage, tip by tip and bit by bit, and then let's see how it goes. And remember, I am Ilechukwu Alex, the CEO of Barcode Infinite. You can visit us on our Facebook page on www.facebook.com/barcodegraphicsnigeria, and then you're going to see more on other tutorials. The slide shows we have on other tutorials. Thank you. Hello and welcome again to Sunset Valley Background Creation. I'm Ilechukwu Alex. I'm going to show you how we created the background that we use for the design. As you can see, we've already done the line drawing for the trees here, the sky, the hills, and then the river here using B-spline 2. You can find B-spline 2 here in Corel 17, Corel 16, but most lower versions of Corel Draw. You can't find B-spline tool, but that doesn't mean you cannot create them. You can actually use freehand tool or other tools to you can use the stop tool to create it, but the faster means of doing it is using the B-spline tool and in the latest version of Corel Draw, which is either 16, Corel 16 or Corel 15. Let's quickly take a look at it. Okay, that's the tool over here. You can find it here. That's the B-spline tool. So you just click and click and click until you get your desired shape. Keep clicking. That's it. As simple as that. So you can use this to create your design. As simple as that. Okay, let's move on. Okay, now you can see we've used the ellipse tool over here to create a shape, circle shape, perfect shape circle for the sun. And then you either use the trimming and welding category to trim off that circle, or you just push it to back of the supposed river over here, so you get what you're looking at now. And then let's give it a very nice subtle color, like a chalk color like this. Make the sky red using your mesh tool over here. You create this, and then you drop. You know, you can do whatever you like. You know, yeah, because you can either create a blue sky, you can either create a pink sky, a dark blue sky, a black sky, in case you want to create a problem. It's about to rain, a dark sky, and the rest of them. Let me quickly show you how to use the mesh tool. Okay, so by clicking, and then you can say add to add another node that will create this line, the imaginary line. I can also double click, just do it the way you like. Put another one here, then selecting this particular node, you can actually drop your color here, or you can actually drag the color to that place over here. Now look, you guys can see the cursor will now change shape. Look at this, and look at this. As you can see, now you release it, so it's basically the same thing. It's like you select and click, or you drag and drop on that node. But mind you, if you mistake to drop it on that node, you can just drop it here, and then it will create another effect. Let's look at it. That's it. So you can drop as many colors as you like. Let's use this. Drop it over here. That's it. And just drop any color you like. So that's how to use the mesh tool. That's one way to use the mesh tool to create something like that. Naturally, select these nodes and then drop your color there. Drop a darker color there. That's it. Okay, let's continue. Okay. Now we are giving the sun a slight shadow here, because we won't want to create the effect of a certain sun, and then in that effect, you shouldn't have a sharp edge for the sun. It should be faded a little bit. So we are going to use the shadow to create the effect we want. Now, as you can see here. Now we want to use the mesh tool to create the sky, and then we're going to add clouds, dark clouds, and then add more effects to it. Now we're using the shape tool to create this shape, and look at what we're going to do with it. Now after creating the shape, because the effect we're going to add to it is a bitmap effect, we are going to add a blur tool to it. So first of all, we cannot add blur feature to a line art. You only add blur feature to bitmap objects, like pictures, and then objects you've already converted to, or line art you've already converted to bitmap. Now we are now converting this shape into a bitmap, so we're gonna add the blur effects to it. Now that's the Gaussian block. If you want to find the Gaussian block, you go to the bitmap. Finding the Gaussian block, let's draw the shape. Let's give it a darker red. That's it. And then let's bitmap. Okay. And then you go to your bitmap, you go to block. And you go to Gaussian blur, and that's it. So you can actually increase your blur effect, and then you have that. That's that. So now, after adding the block, it ends here, as you can see what we've gotten. And then we do the same with another block, it ends here, the yellowish one you're looking at. And then we increase the shadow for the sun. And then look very well here, and then look here. We've already done the same effect, the blood effect on the sun to soften the edges of the sun. That's it here. And then, you know, we add more effects like burns in the certain sun. You know, you just see only the line out of the burns. You don't see the entire thing. So just use a normal beast line tool to get the burns. As simple as that. Click and then you're done. I just reduce the size. That's that. Okay. That's that for our sky. As simple as that. Design whatever I want to be on the sky. But that's that for now. And then we start creating the grasses for the small hill. And then we use our artistic media to just spray the grasses there. And then we start modifying. Okay. Okay, so using your artistic media over here and then selecting plants, select whatever I like. You can use this and create whatever I like. And I use this for your own trees, or you can use this. Okay. That's the one we used. So remember, the more you draw the line, the more grasses you have. And then, because the grasses are still in the artistic media form, shortening it means shortening the line, and shortening the line means making the number of grasses you have shortened. But if you want to retain the same quantity of grasses you have, you now have to break apart. Or if you want to change the size, you can now use the property bar over here and then do your settings. But let us break apart and see what happens. Now, breaking apart, you press Ctrl K on your keyboard, or you come over here, Objects, and you select Break Artistic Media Group Apart. Okay, and then that's the line. You can delete it. Then using this, you can make the grasses smaller over here. Now you can change the color of the grasses. Zoom in a bit. Holding down your Control key, you can now click to select individual grass, and then give it another color you like. And select this, make it this green, and then select this, make it this green. Select this over here, make it this green. Okay, and then do whatever you like to it. Okay, you can now duplicate. So any number you want, selecting, and continue duplicating, and that's that. Okay, that's. Now we have the grasses there. You can now, you know, create more or create less. It's up to you, depending on what you want to create. Remember, what we are creating is the more you look, the less you see. Let us quickly look at how we created the trees. First of all, you can just draw any shape you like, you know, freehand shape or anything. You can actually import pictures if you want, then arrange them in any form you want, because you can have any type of tree you want, any how it looks like is up to you. And then now, as usual, we are going to use our convert it to bitmap, and then use our Gaussian blob to make it look like the way you're seeing now. and then do the same for another one. Remember, you can actually do as many as you like depending on what you want to achieve, and then combine them. This is one, this is two, and this is the third one. Combining the three of them, you know, you are going to get that effect. And then use the transparency tool over here, select all of them, and then make it a uniform transparency over here, and then that's 50% uniform transparency, and then you're going to get exactly what you're looking at now. And then draw, use the B-spline tool, or remember, you can actually use the freehand tool or even the bizarre tool, or anyone you want to achieve this. And then you're going to draw the outline of the tree trunk, and then we'll start coloring. That gives you that color. Remember, you can actually use any color you like. You can design any color of tree you want. You can actually get a greenish tree, it's up to you. But we are going to go with brown for now. And then let's just create this effect here. And then probably we are not going to use it now, but we are going to use it somewhere later. Okay. And then say convert it to bitmap. Remember, look here. We use the blend tool to blend between here and here, blend these two, and then we achieve this. Let's look at the way to one way to use the blend tool. Okay. Let us look at this, and then have a bigger circle here. Selecting this. Okay, selecting this, use your blend tool, and then select this. Remember, you can't apply the blend feature to a bitmap image. You apply the blend feature to line art. That's it. Drag from here to where you want to blend it, and then use the property bar to either increase or decrease the number of objects you are blending. As you can see, it says change the number of steps in the blend or adjust the spacing between the steps. And then we're looking at just only the outline. Let's apply fill. Let's zoom close and apply fill and see how it looks like. This view, and let's take this blue, and then let's remove the outline and see how it looks like. Voila, that's it. So the more we increase the steps, let's make it 50. That's it. So it is as if we used our transparency tool to achieve our panting fill to achieve this. But another use a blend to do that, either you increase or you decrease the number of steps, and then you have the effect you want. And then we're going to use lots and lots of this blend in creating the human beings there, and then lots and lots of the cushion block in creating the human beings there. But back to our story, this is exactly what we did. I'm going to try to duplicate this, make this brown, and let's just go with this, and then okay, we can darken this a bit. Okay, and then let's just go with ordinary brown. That's it. Remove the outline. Use our blend over here, and then blend from here to here. That's it. Smooth blend, and then selecting two of them, you bitmap. Okay, and then you can now apply your cushion block, and then you're going to get just that effect. Okay, now that's how we achieve this. Okay, converting to bitmap, after blending you convert to bitmap, and then the cushion block. Okay, putting this, you can actually find a way to depict shadow, the right side of the tree, casting shadow on the right side of the tree. You can actually depict it the way you want, but this is how we achieve that. Okay, Okay, now as you can see, we actually brought out that stuff we did the blending and the Gaussian blanc on this side, depicting that the setting sun is a true light on this side of the tree, while this side of the tree is backing the setting sun by having the shadow effect you are looking at. Okay, now we brought, remember this, the three shapes we created and then added the Gaussian blanc to it. We brought this one in front to give us the illusion that the branches of the tree are inside the tree. That's it over here. Okay, and then we now soften it again, using our transparency tool to soften it a bit, because it's actually it's going to be in the distance, it's going to be very far from the camera, so it's actually not going to be sharp, it's going to be blurry. You're supposed to get a blurred image when you're looking into a very far distance. So that's actually what we want to create over here. That's it. As you can see, we've actually created the tree and then the leaves and then the branches. It's very far, so we are not supposed to get sharp images, we're supposed to get blonde images. Okay, and then added the second tree and then just tune it a bit. You're using the brightness and contrast feature, you know, just tune it a bit, make some darker, because actually what's the point in creating the dream job where you can actually duplicate what you created and then do one or two adjustments. That's the fun of graphics and that's the fun of CorelDRAW. Okay, as you can see, all we need was to duplicate the trees and then change the brightness and the contrast of the leaves. Okay, same thing is going on here. And then because some are behind and some are in front, and then we want to create a forest. So and then we are not supposed to see everything, all the images, the entire image of a tree. Some will be actually in the dark, and then some will be in the light. So we are going to actually soften the edges of those ones that are supposed to be in the dark, like the ones you're looking at now. So all we did was to use the transparency tool to soften this down here. Okay, that's it. Okay, now we want to create tall grasses, other things that are supposed to be in the forest. Actually, you can actually create animals, monkeys, goats. Goats are just supposed to be in the forest. You understand what I mean? I create whatever you want to be in that forest. But we wanted to create grasses that you will not be seeing the single, you will not be seeing them individually, you just see them collectively. So first of all, we now use our display tool as usual to draw the shape over here and then give it that color. Then using first of all, before you add any bitmap feature, you must convert that line art to bitmap. Now after doing our line art, we made it green color like this, and then convert it to curves. Then use the noise, add noise effect that is in the bitmap. Let's take a look at it. Okay, make it green. Always remember to remove the outline, bitmap, convert to bitmap, and then come down here. You see noise over here. You add noise. Okay. You can actually add, depending on let's use a darker green to see whether we are going to get our effect. Okay, let's use this green. Okay, add noise. Okay, so remember, you can actually use whatever you like to create it, and that's how we achieve that. Let's go back. Okay, that's it over here. Look at the percentage, use random Gaussian, it's like percentage over here. And then we created the second one behind, and then use our our Gosham blood to fade it, make it fade a little bit, so that it will appear to be in the distance, not just what you can see very close to the camera. Well, that's not about that. As you can see, we've created the sky, the setting sun, and then the birds, yeah, and then our trees over here. And then let's move on. Yeah, using our mesh tool over here, we will just create. Remember what I said earlier? We dropped using this node. We dropped red over here. We dropped yellow over here, and then the sun is actually casting an effect on the sky, and then the river is actually reflecting the sky, and then we have a reddish and yellowish sky which is supposed to reflect on our river. So that's actually what we want to create over here. Okay, and this is another fun way of creating waves. You can actually create the waves the way you want, but this is actually the way we achieve our own waves. It's actually a fun way of creating waves. First of all, use your freehand tool this time around, not this line. But you can use this line, but use your freehand tool to make it faster to create. Draw it the way you want, just draw it zigzag, zigzag nature, and then change the color to white. As usual, you bitmap it, then add the Gaussian blur to have that effect you're looking at. So let's just take a look at it. Selecting the three nodes up here, I'm going to use red. Selecting down here, I'm going to use yellow. That's that. I remove the outline. Okay. This time around, I'm going to use our freehand and then just draw. Doesn't matter. Just draw. Okay. Just keep drawing, drawing. Okay. You can actually duplicate it or stretch it the way you want, it's up to you. And then let's make it white. Okay. Increase the number. And then selecting all of them with bitmap. And then as usual, I'm going to use our Gaussian blur. Not too much. Okay. Oh, something like this. Okay, we can actually stretch it. Okay, beautiful. That's actually what you are looking at.
Okay, let us create the illusion that the sun is casting its shadow on the river. As you can see down here, duplicate the sun and cut off this portion, leaving this portion of the sun down here. Using your transparency tool, you fade it a bit so that it won't be as sharp as the original sun itself. Then adding our waves up here, just create the way you like, create any illusion you like, and adding more of the waves, just put it the way, there's no giving formats of doing it, just apply it the way you want, the way you like it. Okay. Now you've seen we've successfully created the sky, the sun, the birds, the trees, forest, and then the waves, the river. Okay, let's add more trees to the forest to make it forest-like. Okay, add more, just duplicate and stretch. There's no format of doing it, just do it the way you want. Okay, that's that. Ah, let's add my good friend, the one paddling a canoe over here. Remember, it's going to be in the distance, so it mustn't be perfect in creating it. Just sketch it the way you want, because actually nobody will zoom close to see it. And when you print it later, nobody will use microscope and start looking at your artwork. Just sketch it the way you want. Okay, that's that. Using your baseline too, you can quickly achieve this. Okay, color it. That's that. And then you can flip it over, duplicate the entire thing, flip it over, bitmap it, and then use the weight paint effect to create this effect you're looking at. And that's that about that. As you can see, nobody will zoom close to start looking at your work. Even if anybody does that, the person is going to see what you're looking at now. So don't worry whether you created it right or wrong. Just go ahead, do what you want. Okay, now we selected the grasses in front here, and then we converted all of them to bitmap so that we can create a blurry effect on it, so that you know, something, things that are close to the camera do not actually look as sharp as those ones that are middle, and those ones that are, well, the ones that are close to the camera are blurred, the ones that are very far from the camera are always blurred. So that we want to create the same effect with the grasses in front here, and then select all of them, convert it to bitmap, then using our Gaussian blur, as you can see, we've blurred the grasses in front here. And that's that about that. We've successfully created the sky, the sun, our birds, the trees here, making the forest over here, and then the grasses over here, and then created the river, the waves, the sun reflection, and then blurred the grasses in front here. So in our next tutorial, we're going to look at how we created the human beings, starting from sketching the first girl over here, and then stay tuned to Backcode Infinite Graphics, and then we'll learn more about creating human beings. Thank you.